Good afternoon, knitters. How are you? Welcome to Recreational Knitting. This is where I have an itty bitty corner of the internets and I talk about what I've knitted, what I'm working on, what yarny delights I've acquired in the past week or so. And you can find me, it's Recreational Knitting Podcast on Instagram. And in Ravelry, you can find me as Sampler Gal. What I'm wearing, this is one of my finished objects. It's the ex-boyfriend's shawl. And I just wanted to show you. This is one where I was here last time. And I've done all of this and all of this this week. This is really what I've worked on the most. I really wanted to get this finished. It's just a, you know, a very simple scarfy kind of thing. And it's, she actually has a pattern for it where you put in so many rows of this color, so many rows of that color, but says do what you want. And that's really what I did. I had two skeins of yarn. I put them in the bag together and decided when I was going to do a stripe. I really like this shape of shawl. It's not been blocked, so it'll be a little bit bigger when I block it out, but I'm glad I got it done. It's when we do a lot of traveling, I can't think and answer questions and pay attention to the scenery around me if I have anything too complicated. Maybe a, you know, vanilla pair of socks and a garter stitch, or, you know, a sweater with just stockinette stitch. That's about as hard as it gets for me when we're traveling. I do my hard knitting when I'm at home, when we're sitting and we're watching TV or something like that in the evenings. That's when I get my harder knitting done. And right now I have the rocket t-shirt that I'm doing, and that's about as hard as my brain is allowing these days. Yeah, it's been a rough couple of weeks, I think. Anyway, that is one of my in the can. Love it. Very happy with it. It's all merino, superwash, sock yarn. The light is Lolo Did It sock base, and this is Zen Garden. And if I had to pick one, it would be the Zen Garden. It's really it's plumpy, luscious, love it. So, one finished object. The second finished object I have to share with you is one that kind of surprised me. I knew I had a little bag of knitting in the car that was leftover yarn from different projects, mostly fingering, and I'm going to put it into a blanket eventually, but you know, I'm just knitting rectangles at this point. And I opened up that bag when I was in the car the other day and found that I had a half completed wash dishcloth. This one, 3 knit stitches, 3 rows of garter, 3 rows of garter. And it, instead of just stocking it, and I think you can see this, so I've just inserted a purl stitch once in a blue moon randomly. It was just something to do. This is car knitting. I do a lot of this in the car knitting, in the car. And it was about half done. And when we went into Memphis yesterday I finished it. So now we have another one. Very good. So two objects in the can, which I feel pretty good about because I don't feel like I've really knit a lot this week. What I want to share with you is that we are currently in Memphis, Tennessee. Outside of Memphis, Tennessee. We're actually in northern Mississippi, which is right on the line of Memphis. And we've spent, this will be our third night, here at a campground. It's a Corps of Engineers. If you don't know about the Corps of Engineers campgrounds, and you are a camper, you really should look it up. They're great. They really are great. They're mostly have electric and some have water. They also have a dump station, usually. And right now we're at a campground that has full hookups. So those of you that camp know that black tank is connected to our own little septic system. So it's really kind of nice. We're near a lake, huge man-made lake. What the Corps of Engineers does is they come in and they make a reservoir, if you will. It's water management. And then around that project, they will typically install campgrounds so that there's some revenue coming back into the United States government, which is really quite good. They're usually about $22 a night. Really, really recommend them, those of you that are campers. What I really wanted to show you today was my new t-shirt. I have to stand up. It's the Lorraine Motel t-shirt, which houses the National Civil Rights Museum. We went there yesterday and had a wonderful time. You know, you think you know a lot about the civil rights movement. Sorry, there's all kinds of bugs out here. I guess I'm in the South in what's starting to be summer. You think you know a lot about civil rights, but we really, both of us, learned a lot about civil rights. Obviously, the Lorraine Motel is where Dr. Martin Luther King was killed. And we were able to go and see the exact room and then go across the street and see the boarding house where his assassin killed him. It was very moving, very well done. And I suggest those of you that have never been that a trip to Memphis is worth it. Really is. It's quite nice. So we are now in Memphis. Now I'm going to show you my works in progress. Things that I have on my needle. Oh, wait a minute. I have another finished object, which is really a hoe. Okay. So this is my sock. These are the Rose City Rollers pattern. And this is where I was the last time I showed you. So I finished the toe, bound off. It has not been blocked either. And I started the second sock. These are going to go to my daughter, I think. I think they're going to fit her rather than me. She's got a smaller foot. But yeah, this has been languishing in my bag and I hadn't picked it up. And I said, this is ridiculous. I really need to get these done because they're shorties, they're easy. You know, a couple nights and they'll be done. So yeah, so I finished this one a couple nights ago. And today when we went into Memphis, I started the second one. These are kept in my favorite bag. All my socks are kept in this, where the Kitchener stitch is explained, because I need it explained every single time I do it, no matter how many times I've done it. Too many steps. Anyway, so that's where I keep my current socks. So that's a hoe. That's pretty good. 2.5 objects done. Very good. What's next? Hey, we've got over 100 subscribers. Do you know what that means? We're gonna have a giveaway. Hold on to the end. This is my rocket tee that I've worked on and 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 then ripped and worked on and worked on. I've knit this sweater at least once by now, and it's not even joined at the front where the V comes in. But as you can see, maybe you can see, this is where I was the last time we talked, and a couple rip outs and a couple put back ins. I don't know why this is so hard for me, but it's really requiring a lot of mental stuff. You know, I'm hoping I'm not always going to be this way, but it's been a rough couple of weeks, as I said. So yeah. So anyway, I'm holding these two double right now. This is made by Ito from Japan. These are both 100% wool in the mustard color. And then when we go to the next stripe, I hold one of the wool with an oatmeal silk, also made by Ito. I think it's gonna be nice. I think I'm gonna love it when it's done. It may drive me a little cuckoo in the meantime, but we've all had projects that for some reason, they're very simple, just doesn't click. This is one of those for me. I really want to make this sweater though. I think it would be easier if I didn't have two lace weight yarns, but you know, that's what I decided on and that's what's going to happen. So anyway, that's, I actually keep one of the spools on one of these, to help roll it out. That's it. I've worked a little bit on a couple of other things. My son-in-law's scarf. I've worked a little bit on my mustard-colored sweater. But mostly I worked on the shawl. And some weeks are like that. Don't have a whole lot to knit. So what I decided to do is, a couple weeks ago, I showed you all my socks, my full socks. Well, now I'm going to show you all my shorties, because I wear shorties a lot. We live in South Florida, and that's really what I wear. My first pair of socks, plain old vanilla socks. These were toe up, plain old gusset heel, not even a bird of eye. What do you call that? Bird's eye. It's just a plain old stockinette heel. And these were once very vibrant yellow and black, which I really, really liked. And this yarn, I don't know now who the yarn is by, but I know they no longer dye. And this was on a sale in Monterey, California, when we were camp hosting there. And I know why, because the black just kept bleeding and bleeding and bleeding. And, you know, while I still love them, they're not as vibrant. They were very yellow when I first knit these. They were beautiful. Still nice, but that's one pair. This is some kind of sock yarn. Not sure what the brand is, but it's one of those self-striping regia. I'm just not sure. Toe up, that's how I make my socks typically, is toe up. This one I have the, what is that called? Why is it I can't remember that? The something about a bird. Anyway, yeah, so did that heel, gusset, and just up around the top. These are one of my favorite. They fit the best. And you know how it goes. You make a pair of socks and sometimes they really fit great and sometimes they're like, what happened? Speaking of what happened, here's another pair that I wear. But one of the tops is larger than the other. So I don't know whether I miscounted. I don't know what I did. My gauge was off at the ribbing. But again, another sock yarn. I'm not sure what the brand is. This might be online. I'm not certain. But it's a superwash. All of the last two pairs have been superwash. But yeah. I don't get too fancy with my socks. But these I got a little fancier with. These are made with Wollmies yarn from Germany, and they're toe up, and I did a little edging. These are one of my favorite socks too, but because of the fit, nothing else, and just a plain gusset heel. And they're a 3x1 rib. Yeah, these are one of my favorites because they fit really well, but they don't go with a lot of things. So that's another one. These are another one of my favorites, very similar to those in the same 3x1, except this time on the bottom of the sock, I just left it stockinette instead of the 3x1 on top. And again, it has the fancy schmancy little ribbing, the ribbing and turned over. Again, they don't go with everything, but they fit well. These are the socks that I should not have made socks from. This is Emma's yarn, and it's got some cashmere in it, if you can believe it. These are the softest socks I've ever had, and I love them. They fit well. I do treat them like they're precious, which they kind of are. Again, just a plain vanilla but it's one of my favorite. This colorway is just joyful to me. It's just, I love that together. And this is some unidentified 100% merino, don't know what it is, fingering weight that was in my stash that had been in there for so many years. Again, a vanilla sock. These go in shoes. Nobody sees them except me and Luke, and that's it. But I love these colors. It's a tan and a teal and a gray, and it's just wonderful. I really do enjoy that color. But they're 100% merino, so I do have to treat them a little precious. I know what these are. These are Cascade Heritage sock yarn. And what is funny is that one of the times I blocked them on the blocker, sock blockers, is that, I don't know whether you can see it, but I had one of to the sun and one side wasn't to the sun. And they were out there a little too long, so they got sun bleached. So when they're on your foot, sorry about that. Thunderstorm warning. Like I didn't know that between the clouds and what was going on. So these are Cascade. Great sock yarn. Love it. And I've worn those to pieces. These are ones that I was gifted by a good friend of mine who knits far better than I. Just want you to see how wonderfully those are put together. She has her own little pattern. It's kind of like Hermione's, not sure what the pattern is. I have it somewhere, but she does a much better job of knitting than I. Remember, I'm the mediocre knitter. Then I have some here that are total merino. Boy, I need to go through my sock drawer and fold them better, because they've really, they're not doing so good here. Anyway, I love these. These are 100% merino, again. I've had to repair these up here, and I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't have any more of the yarn left. So, but they work. Again, these are some of my favorite, and I treat them preciously because they are merino. But another pair of socks. These are just the ones that I've kept for myself. These are a pair of socks that I got this yarn somewhere on sale. I think it's a Regia yarn. I'm not certain. Don't hold me to that. It's a sock yarn. And it was just so bright and cheerful that I had to get this yarn. So there's two of them. They're almost matchy-matchy. Almost. They're about a quarter of an inch off. I don't care. I never do. So it just kind of happened to work that way for this. I should get my sock blocker out here for these so that they would look nicer, right? Now, I'm rather much of a Baltimore sports enthusiast, so I like the Orioles. So I made myself some Oriole socks. These are my Oriole socks. And every time I wore these to a game, they won. Now that was back a few years. And these are the only socks that I kept from when I lived in Baltimore. The others have come since. But these are my Oriole socks. Again, I don't know the name of the sock yarn. Superwash wool, nylon, great, love them. And these are my Baltimore Raven socks. These are made with Cascade sport weight. I can squeeze them in a couple pairs of tennis shoes, but mostly these are for sitting around watching the Ravens play during football season. Again, not matchy-matchy, but almost. One of my favorite pairs of socks. They're so soft. They're so soft, I thought that they were acrylic when I got them, but they really are a sock yarn. Very nice. If you want sport weight, Heritage really is a nice fabric when you get it knit up. So, those are all my shorties, I think. I think those are it. So, I just want to thank you for being here, for subscribing, for commenting. I'm really hoping that I can grow this channel, this community. I'd like to do giveaways and all kinds of things. And now that we're over 100, I do have a giveaway. I have Zombie Yarns. And this is the Alive colorway. And it's 100% superwash merino, approximately 490 yards. So this is a lot of yardage that it can be made into. You can make it into socks if you'd like, but truly I would probably make this into a shawl. Just to show you some of the colors that you'll be getting if you win this giveaway. Isn't it beautiful? It's got a little pink in there, white, like a turquoise blue, some purples. Really a pretty yarn. Oh, goodness. Let's see if I can wrap this. Let's see how many times I need to do this. It's catching on my sweaty thumb. I think I'll do this after we talk. How about that? I'll just put it there. And I'll throw in some other little treats here and there. I have a little stitch marker that was gifted to me by an Etsy seller. And just as a thank you note, you know, she sent me an extra little thanks. So I'll throw that in there. I think that's adorable. All day sucker. So, to be eligible for this, you have had to come to the end of this podcast, number one. Number two, you have to have liked this episode. You've had to subscribe to the episode, to me, my channel, and you have to answer a question in the comments. You have to leave a comment and you have to answer this question. The question is, what color would you knit with if you could only knit with one color the rest of your life? What color would that be? It's a tough one. I like all the colors. I have to say, at this point in my life, it would be blue. What would be your favorite color the rest of your life? So, those are the rules. We'll pick the next time. Remember to like, subscribe, comment, and spread the word. Thanks for coming. I do appreciate all the support that I'm getting. I'm pretty amazed, actually. So, thank you very much. Enjoy the rest of your day. And I'm hoping that peace comes soon to our world. Bye.